Now, as you just mentioned to me, you're the fiduciary for the New York City pension plans. It's the fourth largest public pension in the country.
Yeah.
I'm not sure everyone appreciates that. So you actually made money over these last 2 days with Facebook. The stock value went up.
You lose money and you make money. But remember, managing a pension fund, you're a long-term investor. So we don't worry really about the ups and downs.
Were you happier with your investment after you saw what Mr. Zuckerberg had to say over 2 days?
Look, we've been very clear, as in my role as fiduciary, to suggest to Facebook and Mr. Zuckerberg that they have a problem. There's been a serious data breach, as you saw with some of the congressional questions. So we have to have action. And part of what we've proposed is that we separate out Mr. Zuckerberg's role as CEO and chairman of the board so that we can bring in new independent directors who have real experience on data, on law, and on transparency, because we're rooting for Facebook because we invest in it for our firefighters, our teachers, and our city workers.
And it was widely reported that you wrote a letter, actually, to them saying, we really want you to do this. Are you getting support from other pension plans?
I think people are starting to weigh in. There's genuinely concern. I mean, I thought the hearings were fascinating because there's definitely a disconnect between the immense intelligence that Mark Zuckerberg has on this whole issue of data and Facebook, and our elected officials, I think, are really playing catch up with the world. So I think there has to be more scrutiny, there has to be more discussion, but Facebook has to act to restore the confidence of the share owners like myself on behalf of the people I represent.
Why would separating out the role of chairman from CEO accomplish that? I mean, is it a matter of Mr. Zuckerberg doesn't have enough time to do both?
I think part of it is time. You know, the CEO should really spend as much resources and time to figure out some of the challenges that Facebook has to deal with.
Here's what I struggle with, though. You're a shareholder, but you want them to spend then more money on trying to deal with protection, which is going to wind up hurting their margins and could impact their ad revenue. How do you square that?
We're not really talking about money. We're talking about focus.
Well, they're going to hire 10,000 people to go through all the security.
In a company that large, 10,000 people may seem a lot if you own a deli, but it's not for Facebook. They have to scrutinize and they have to root out this. Because, look, there's reputational risk, there's regulatory risk, and there's a risk to our democracy, and Facebook has to own up to that. And we've challenged public companies before to do the exact same thing, and that's what our job is as fiduciaries and share owners. We own $1 billion in stock. We should have a say. We should have concerns. You know, Mark Zuckerberg controls 60% of that company with 16% of the shares, so he's already very influential.
So Facebook has been a good investment for you and really for your pension holders.
Yes. And
they're getting paid their pension by that. How do you weigh, on the one hand, making sure those pension holders get their pensions, and that requires them to make a lot of money, with some of the things you'd like them to do?
Because we are acting through the lens of being a fiduciary, someone who's protecting the financial interests of people whose retirement security depends on all of this. And these questions are best practice. Separate CEO and chair, add more independent directors, have more transparency, and then let's get to the root of what's happening here. Our democracy is at stake, and one of the biggest companies in the world that we invest in is also at stake.
If they don't listen because of the voting rights, do you sell your shares?
Oh, we're not even at that point. You know, we're long-term investors. We ask these questions. No decisions like that have
been
made.
But my point is that if you're not willing to back it up with something because you don't have voting rights, why would Facebook pay attention?
Because I think they worry, like we worry, about reputational harm. And we're going to use every lever we have to ask these questions. And by the way, by asking these questions, it's created a platform for congressional hearings, the questions you're going to ask Facebook. And that's part of our role.
How effective have shareholders like you, the pension holders, been in changing really fundamental corporate behavior? Have you had success in doing this? Have you seen others have success in doing this?
Look, we've challenged corporations that have not been good actors, whether it's Wells Fargo or other areas. We have not been afraid to engage these companies. We now have proxy access shareholder victories in 450 companies, so we have now the right to run independent directors. There is a activism on behalf of our share owners and our retirees, and I think it's a role that more people should play. And in New York City, I've decided to play it as much as I can.
Let's talk about other areas that you might play in. So I spoke with Anne Finucane of Bank of America yesterday. She runs their ESG, and she talked about their loans to gun companies. Here's what she had to say.
We do have a few manufacturers of military-style firearms. We're in discussions with them. We have let them know that we are going to, it's not our intent to underwrite or finance military-style firearms on a go-forward basis.
So, question for you, what are you doing with gun stocks and other stocks that are in the spotlight like coal?
We've worked to divest from guns, and we have. We've divested from coal, and we continue to divest. And we do this, by the way, through the lens of, will this in any way harm the bottom line, our investments? And when we do our due diligence, in the case of guns and in the case of coal, we have not had any negative impact to our pension fund. And I think it's totally appropriate to get out of guns as much as any bank or anyone else can. The mass shootings that are happening in this country is because of weak laws and foolish people, and the collateral damage to this country is enormous.
So you say thus far it has not hurt your returns. Would you be willing to give up any of your returns at all in order to effectuate some of these changes?
You know, as my role is to make sure that we push the envelope, but again, I have a due diligence that I take very seriously. We are exploring, for example, divesting further in terms of fossil fuels, but again, we study, we analyze, and we do things in a way that only enhances the pension fund. Because look who I represent, the teacher, the city worker, the person who really relies on us to be mm-hmm. their retirement. So we can't harm them, but there are issues around the country and the world that we have to speak up about, because it ultimately hurts the people I represent.